Okay, welcome to our talk. Maybe you can sit down here, some free chairs left.
Yeah, there's still some free space. You can have a chair.
Come over. Especially everybody who's also running a public cloud is warmly welcome.
Yeah.
Because that is what we will talk about.
How we operate a public cloud.
But maybe we start with a short introduction. My name is Jan. I'm working in the cloud team at SysElevn. SysElevn is a cloud provider. Basically, we are offering infrastructure as a service, and we do managed hosting also. That is where the company comes from. And yeah, what will we talk about in this talk? If you're running a public cloud, you have to face a few challenges. For example,
I also need to introduce myself.
Maybe we don't start with the talk.
I'm Steffen. I'm also working in the cloud team. And we are a pretty small team, fairly small team of around 11 people working in the team, running and developing our cloud offering. So some of us have a software development background like myself, and some of us have an operations background. And that leads to some interesting solutions. But yeah, let's start with the challenges.
Yeah.
If you are a public cloud provider,
What happens if you're running a public cloud? So basically you have your infrastructure set up, you have your hypervisors, you have your guest machines, you have your users starting their VMs, and then something nasty comes from the outside, something like meltdown, any other influence from the outside.
These threats are very severe for a public cloud.
Yeah, basically what happens
offering.
If you don't act on these threats, I think the scenarios that you have one user starting one VM and an attacker can read data from another customer. That is what's behind all these threats that run there. What do you do usually if you have these threats or threatened computers? You just do a simple fix?
It's easy, right? You can just update and reboot.
So basically, yeah. What happens if you want to handle this threat? You need to install a fresh package of software. So basically, new Linux kernel or what did we had in the past? Microcode updates is a nice example. You need to do that, and to handle that, you have to restart your computers. So that's pretty easy. You have to shut down your computer, put it online back again, and that's it. Usually.
And the important part is for most of these updates to take effect, you need to reboot the computer. Without it, it doesn't matter that you update it at all.
Yeah.
So what is the customer's point of view on this? Because our customers run critical businesses on top of our offerings.
Yeah. Let's have a look at the basically, business. From a customer perspective, the world is also very easy. They want their VMs up all the time, and they want a secured environment. So that's all they want. So it's a very primitive world until now. But it gets more and more complicated if you have a look at the details. So some of you operate in OpenStack cloud, and you know it's in itself it's a complex system. So and even if it wouldn't be a complex system, it is a challenge just by we run a medium-sized environment, I would say. But to react on the errors we had in the past year, we had to do 2,500 reboots in a not-so-large environment.
So this sounds very painful at first. So why are we doing this?
Yeah, basically, the answer is given because we want to be our users on the safe side. We have to reboot. There's no other choice. So there's a critical bug outside. We have to install updates, and we have to reboot the whole cloud multiple times a year. And that is what we do. The other possibility is also now we could do it like others did in the past. We could never touch the system again, and then the user requirement to be available would be met, but not the other requirement to be on the safe side. And that is why we have to go the painful way and reboot the cloud.
But also doing it often has a big advantage here, because if you have to make changes, it's better to make apply a small set of changes, because if you break something, then you can see more easily what was the breaking change and react quicker on that. So this is one of our underlying principles. If we have to do it, we want to do it every week.
So now we are at the point where we saw that it makes sense to reboot often and to reboot often. And then we started to reboot the cloud by hand. I think some of you might remember how we started the project. We just sat there and rebooted machines. That was the first approach. So sitting in front of an SSH terminal and typing reboot was the beginning of the story. But we very quickly ended up not to do that, because it was human work, and that annoys humans. That is one reason.
There's another drawback.
But there's another drawback. Let's be honest.
The other thing is, clouds, running an OpenStack cloud is really complicated. There's lots of distributed systems, and many of them are stateful, and they are important. You need them to keep the APIs working, you need them, but you also need them to keep the VMs working. So for example, our virtual machines are running on a Qobyte distributed storage, and every file is replicated 3 times in our data center. And if you accidentally reboot 2 compute nodes, that might end up in a problem for the customer, and the customer's VM will just stop working.
So to make the problem really clear from a customer perspective, the cloud is down if more than 2 data nodes, or if more than 1 data node is lost and 1 is in maintenance, then we have a huge problem. And that is what we have to avoid in production.
Yeah.
And that is what we are going to talk about, how we did that.
So how do you do that? If we established we have to reboot so often, how do we do that?
Yeah. Any idea? Anybody have an idea how to reboot 2,500 times without making any mistake?
Cluster SSH. Cluster SSH. Good idea.
Thanks, Harald, for the hint. I think we didn't try that. Cron drops is also a very good example.
Maintenance window.
Yeah, the users usually love that.
Our users love that, yeah.
Very sure, yeah.
Let's see.
We could also exchange the users, yeah, if they are complicated, if they demand something.
Yeah, we can find better customers.
Yeah. Another solution. Okay, but our solution is that we have to do it. We don't want to do it by hand, so we have to automate it. That's the thing. And
to automate this, we need a different view onto our cluster. So what everyone of us already has is the should be state. Usually we do configuration management or something else in Kubernetes. We write YAML files to express what the should be state of our cloud is. And we want, for example, 3 Galera nodes, and we want so many compute nodes and so on. And this is the should be state. Everyone has that. But what you need to automate a reboot is also to gather the actual state. And that's where we use Consul for. Consul is a great product from HashiCorp. It is very powerful, but it's at the same time very simple. Let's go to the screenshot.
Yeah.
Or is there something? So this is a screenshot of our Consul web interface. And as you can see, there is a service registry. So you can register services in Consul. And as you can already see in a real installation, some services are always, maybe not always, but most of the time, something is down, because you need to do some maintenance, or you have a hardware failure, or anything else. And this is what Consul can give you. You can register services, you can register checks, and the good thing is, with a very simple API, you can write code that has a complete cluster overview. What Consul also provides is a key value store, so you can store data or configuration or anything else in a key value store. And it also provides primitives to implement distributed locking and semaphores. And this was a really useful tool for us, automating the reboots.
Yeah, what we want to achieve is that no human is involved in rebooting the cloud anymore. And console is the core component that makes that possible for us, because it replaces the guy who sits in front of the monitoring and has a look if everything is green. That is automated with console. That's the backbone of our procedure, I would say. So it's very, very important. It doesn't look that important, but it is, because with console we have the actual cluster state, and with that we can do automated decisions if it's good to reboot or not. So that is what we use it for.
So now we can make the decision to reboot, but who actually makes this decision? And if we don't involve any humans? So our reboot manager works in 11 simple steps, and it's basically a cron job. every node decides on its own, so we don't have a central place where we make the decision, okay, you have to reboot now. Every node will check for in a regular interval, hey, is it necessary to reboot? Did I install updates previously that need a reboot? Is there a new kernel installed, and so on? If yes, it will go to the next step, and it will try to get a lock in console. And if that is successful, it will ask console, the service registry, if all cluster services are actually right now okay. So if we have three Galeras, are all three Galeras really green? Because if yes, they can lose a member. In the storage system, for example, if you reboot a compute node, it will run on this compute node and will look on, connect to the local console agent and ask which services are running on my machine right now, and are all services in the whole cluster with this name green? And then it's usually okay to reboot.
Yeah, and also it has the possibility to do any action before rebooting or after rebooting. So one example is to just migrate live migrate VMs away for a simple compute node, or do any post or pre action on that task. So basically, yeah, rebooting is a predefined routine, and it happens every time, and that is what happens in the background here.
And we try to keep it really simple and stupid, so it doesn't have a plug-in system or something like that. You have just on every machine, you have a directory with pre-boot tasks and post-boot tasks, and those are executables. They will be run in alphabetical order. And if they fail, the machine will not reboot.
So if we do a quick summary of the whole process, it is distributed. It runs on every node in the cluster. So, and it is very simple. It is 300 lines of code or something like that. And the information backbone is, as we already said, console. So every machine in the cluster is aware of the whole cluster state, and that makes it very, very powerful. It is very small, it is very primitive, but it is powerful enough to, maybe let's see it in action. How does it look like to reboot a cloud?
This is from yesterday, and our whole engineering team is on this conference, and still we had some rebooting servers yesterday.
This is our production system. So while we attend some interesting talks at an interesting conference, we have enough trust in this simple mechanism to reboot the production system. And that is what is cool from our point of view.
Yes.
So.
And the best thing?
The best thing is it's now open source.
Today we released it on GitHub. So if you want to use it, feel free to go to this page, have a look there. We published this just a few minutes ago. We have some unit tests. Thank you.
So.
And let's go to the next slide. This is only possible because of our awesome team. Thank you, everyone. So. Most of the code was actually written by Dennis on the top left. And the last few days, me and Alexandre, we implemented some unit tests, or integration tests, better. Yeah. Thank you.
And that's the
whole story. Come to our booth. We have a booth here. We have a lounge downstairs. And feel free to talk to us. Our whole engineering team is here. You can find us easily with these jackets or the SysEleven logo. And we are really happy to talk to you.
Yeah. Do you have any questions here? Because we have some minutes left.
Yeah. I think we have a microphone for questions, do we? Okay.
So,
you have any questions? Please raise your hand.
If everything is clear, then thanks for your time. And we can talk at our booth.
There's a question.
There's a question. Okay.
Hello. I have a question about monitoring of status of cluster of databases.
Yeah.
Are there any sophisticated mechanism or just checking if every node is up? Because it's not sufficient in many cases, in most of the cases.
So Consul has a multiple ways of implementing checks. So built in, it has the ability to just look if, for example, a port is reachable, but this is not enough, as you say. That's why you can also add script checks, which will run a script. In our case, we monitor Galera with a Python script that we wrote that will check everything. Is every Galera node really master in a master state? Is the replication working okay, and so on? So we really check if it's really, really working, if it can really lose a member. So all important services, our checks are only green if the cluster can lose a member.
Yeah, and you have to keep one other feature of Consul in mind, that is the locking mechanism. So basically, only one node can grab this lock, and with that we are able to really assure that in certain groups only one node goes down. So for Galera clusters, the example where it's very clear that you can only lose one node, but it also is important for our storage nodes to not lose any data or slow down the cluster or something like that.
We have a feature idea. It's actually already, I can show you the website. Can I show you the website?
I think so.
Because we also published our design document on GitHub. /sys11/reboot-manager. Oh.
Du kannst den Browser rüberschieben, oder?
Okay.
Yeah, that works.
So, this is the live demo. So, we also have our design document on GitHub. And we were also thinking about a feature, we didn't implement it yet, where we can say, for example, this service needs at least this amount of checks passing. For example, if you have a stateless API, maybe it's okay to lose three API backends, but some services maybe can lose one member or two, and we didn't implement that yet, but feel free to ask for that feature in the issues. Feel free to collaborate with us. We would really love to see your feedback on this.
Any other questions left? Someone of you, does any one of you face the same challenges, for example? No, Harald, you're not. You're not doing that.
Can you hear me? Okay. Just wondered, like when there's a flaw discovered, say Meltdown, have you used Reboot Manager for that already? And how long does it take you to reboot the whole production since you only have a single lock?
That's so an interesting question, yeah.
If if everything goes right, all our nodes are rebooted after 2 weeks.
And the thing is that we don't use Reboot Manager for one special error or something like that. We are not event-driven. That is something that runs all the time. That is the major difference. So we don't have to need to, as a manager, sit together, do risk analysis or something like that. We don't, it's just a proven process and we can, it just runs. So.
So for a regular compute storage node, how long does the one node take in the process from I'm getting the lock until I release the lock? Is it like 20 minutes or is there some more stuff involved in that?
It mainly depends on how many virtual machines are running on the compute node. If it's a compute node, you have to migrate them. We don't want to live migrate every VM at once. We have pretty big compute nodes. So 500 gigabyte of RAM or more. In latest generation, 700 gigabyte of RAM. So it can take quite a while to migrate all of these VMs. So it's like, yeah, maybe maximum 2-3 hours at the moment. But we are not yet in a scale where we have to do parallel reboots. This would be a feature we would add as soon as we need it. But right now we have sufficient cluster size is not so large that we need to be aware of that.
And the other thing is that we have two clusters who operate in parallel, so we don't have any time issues at the moment, timing issues.
Yeah, the different regions are in a different console cluster, and so in every console cluster they will reboot in parallel. So per console cluster there's one reboot in parallel. So if you have maybe availability zones, you could implement that as well with different console regions.
Oh. Cool. Time is up now. If you have other questions, our booth is over there. And I think today we also will be at the Sys11 lounge downstairs. You can find us here. We wear these jackets. The whole team is here. You can talk to the engineers. So feel free. And thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.